30,000 watt auto-ranging Agilent power supply. This is the newer version, which has been introduced about 20 years ago for ease and for better performance. The next step in the process is to remove the top cover from the instrument. And the top cover can be removed, and this information is shown in the manual, by removing the screws and the handles from each side of the cover. And the inner cover is also removed by 4 screws on the top and 3 screws on either side, and that cover is removed. Now that your instrument is opened and you have access to all the electronics inside the box, the GPIB board, which is shown here, can be easily removed by removing these 2 cables, removing this cable that comes from the front panel, and removing 2 screws from the rear. If this GPIB board or interface board is defective, the tested number that's available through Support Products Organization is 5063-3463. To complete the job, there are 2 screws that need to be removed from the rear of the instrument that will allow you to get the GPIB board out of the instrument. At this point, there's some interesting fact that needs to be addressed, and that is, if customers who have older revision boards with 2 board sets are not backwards and forwards interchangeable. If you have a newer unit with the 1 board that has more capability than the old ones do, that was part of the reason for the change, the rear chassis has to be changed if you were trying to put the new board into an older instrument, and the bias transformer also needs to be replaced. So Agilent was able to continue to support the older 2 board set as shown, and this is in part 1 of a previous video, and the 1 board GPIB interface. When the board or any other component in the instrument has been replaced, replace the inner cover and put all the screws back in as you took them out. Replace the outer cover using the proper hardware, and this information is also stated in the manual. And one thing very important is that always working on these units, you do 2 important things. Make sure that the AC line is unplugged from the wall, and use ESD protection while handling intricate